Hello and welcome to another installment in the HPRC video tutorial series. In this video, you'll learn what a batch system, or scheduler, is, as well as how to submit a job to Terra's batch system, SLURM. This video is recommended to be watched after the previous videos in our Getting Started series. It's important to keep in mind that the clusters are a shared resource between many users. When performing small tests or managing files, it's convenient for users to simply run their commands on a login node. But for work requiring more than 8 cores, the compute nodes must be used to prevent users from impeding each other. To run your job on the compute nodes, you'll create a job script, which basically consists of a list of shell commands to run. Aside from that, you'll also specify job parameters. For example, how many cores you need, how much memory the job requires, how long the job needs to run, etc. After that, you'll submit the job to the job scheduler, and the job scheduler will find the available resources to run your job. The Terra Cluster's batch system, SLURM, has specific syntax for its job files. The easiest way to start making a job file is to modify the pre-made templates on the HPRC wiki page, which is linked in the description below. From the main wiki page, we can click on Terra on the left-hand navigation bar under User Guides, then click on the Batch Job Examples link. So as you can see, this section provides a few different kinds of templates for different kinds of jobs. First and simplest is the single core, single node job, also called serial job. There's also job file templates for multi-core single node or multi-core multi-node. Additional templates are available for jobs that may require a specific queue on the cluster, such as the case when jobs must be run on a GPU or KNL node. Note that running a job with multiple cores or nodes does not automatically make it parallel. You'll need additional software for this, and it's not guaranteed to run faster in parallel. So for this video, I'm going to go ahead and copy this whole template. So let me just add that it's easiest to create job files on the cluster itself rather than on your personal machine. That way, the job file is ready to be given to SLURM. Otherwise, your job file will need to be transferred to the cluster from the machine you're editing on. In addition to being more tedious, this can also lead to errors with job execution. For example, if the job file was written on a Windows machine, it will have invisible carriage return line feed characters, or CRLF characters, which are not compatible with Unix-based systems. So if needed, information on file uploading can be found in our earlier videos in the Getting Started series. HPRC also provides a solution to this CRLF problem with the DOS to Unix command. This command automatically will remove the CRLF characters in the job file, and more information on this can be found by searching DOS to Unix on the wiki page. I'll also provide a link to that page in the description. So to create a new job file, I can type in nano, which is the name of my text editor of choice, and then the name of my job, which I called mynewjob.sh. So now that I'm in the text editor, I can paste in the template from the wiki page, and we can begin editing. So let's say in my hypothetical job, I'm going to need 8 gigs of memory, so I'll just round that to about 8,000 megabytes. So let's say my job will be processing datasets in Python, and I think it'll take about 2 hours. As I said, it's better to be generous with this, so I'm going to say 3 hours just in case it goes over. That way my job won't crash. So in the optional job specifications, I can remove the example email and add my own. This way I'll know when my job starts and stops. So now we're ready to input commands that the job actually needs to run. And as I said, I'll be processing datasets in Python in this hypothetical job, but before I can do any sort of processing with Python, I've got to load the Python module first. I'll be using this version, but you can use any version that you like. If you're not familiar with our module system already, we have a video on it earlier in our Getting Started series, as well as a page for it on our wiki. So now that I've loaded the Python module, my Python script has the proper environment to run on, so it can be executed. So I'll give Python my script here. For monitoring purposes, I want this job to run for a bit, so in lieu of having anything better to run, I'll add a simple delay in that script. So now that my job file is complete, I can save it, Control O, Enter, and then execute. And now my job's ready to be given to the scheduler. So to give the job file to the scheduler, I type sbatch, the name of the job, and note that this argument for sbatch is a file path. I can just write the name of the job because I'm currently in the same directory that the job is in. Okay, so I'll go ahead and submit that. I can now check the status of all my jobs using this command, sq-u for user, and then type my net ID. So more information on all this can be found in the job submission and job monitoring sections of the Terra Batch page that I showed before. So I can verify that my job ran correctly by now opening the output file that I mentioned before. Now in my job script, I didn't change the name of the output file. It was just example out 1 followed by the job ID, which, and just to make sure, I can actually ls, and then I will open this using the cat command. And you can see that everything ran as expected. So our job is done. Thank you so much for watching this instructional video. Be sure to check out our other videos and subscribe to our channel to get updates about new videos. You can also follow us on Twitter at tamu_HPRC, listed here, or click the link to our account on the HPRC main page, also linked in the description.